because I can't get it lifted.
In 1972, a group of musicians began a rock band dedicated to bringing the message of Christ to young people by using rock music. During the last 13 years, Petra has grown from the foundations of the Jesus music of the 70s to one of the 80s leading forces in contemporary Christian music. As this music has changed, so has Petra. This group, who served as pioneers cutting paths and trails through the early forest of contemporary Christian music, have brought excitement to Christian rock. How has all of this happened? Why have these guys lasted so long? Let's check it out and go behind the scenes to find out why. One of the big reasons Petra is so effective is because young people find them entertaining. But their music is their ministry. So which is it? Ministry or entertainment?
Without a doubt, Petra is a blend of ministry and entertainment. As a matter of fact, you'd have to say that we're a delicate balance between the two. We don't apologize or make excuses for the fact that we entertain our audiences. As a matter of fact, it is intentional. We don't entertain at the expense of ministry. Ministry is the bottom line. That's why we're doing what we're doing.
Since the group centers on entertainment and ministry, they believe their central purpose in the ministry is well defined.
We are definitely a ministry, and we want to reach young Christians and be able to give them positive input. We want to be able to edify them as young people. The other thing we want to do as musicians is we want to provide quality music for all people. Young people that don't know the Lord, we want to challenge them with the message that's in our music.
One of the things we do to involve churches is we ask people in local churches that have counseling experience to be a part of our counseling unit that comes to the concert and counsels kids who make decisions and come forward. We have people there that can talk to kids if they need to be talked to. And this, again, is another way of the churches locally being able to personally touch the kids who make commitments to see that their walk with the Lord gets carried through.
One very important factor with Petra is that young people will find their concerts different from a night with a secular artist. And it begins in the planning stages.
Well, I think there's a tremendous difference between our concerts and a rock concert, starting at the very beginning with our production company when it comes into a hall. They're not just a road crew setting up equipment. They're also trying to be real courteous and trying to exemplify a Christ-like attitude so that they can actually minister their faith of being Christians by the way they work. So we've had a lot of reports back from people said this road crew is one of the best we've ever encountered, not just being professional, but courteous also.
10 o'clock we're unloading the trucks is normal. Everything should be finished by 2 p.m., all the heavy stuff, everything should be in place. At that point, we start focusing.
All right.
5 o'clock, we do a sound check. Now, you let me know if this schedule, if you need any changes on the schedule, because we'll work within your confines, too.
Yeah, I don't think we've got a problem there. You know.
6 p.m., we clear a stage. The show starts at 8.
The first thing they'll see is the sound and the flashing lights, and all outside appearances would seem to appear that it's a regular rock concert, but that's where the similarity ends. Because when we start singing our songs, we start expressing our faith in Jesus Christ as our Savior, and also the exhortation between the songs, that is definitely different from a rock concert.
It keeps the kids open, saying, well, this isn't slack. It doesn't, you know, they haven't held back. This is like a real rock show. Like our staging is custom built. It was featured on Performance Magazine along with Kenny Loggins' set. It's just good, clean sound. And the good clean sound helps you to be able to hear all the different instruments plus the vocals, and brings out the words of the song, which is that aspect of the concert is the most important thing. This is the message that we're trying to bring across to the kids. There's about 300 pars, I think. It's got a computerized lighting board. It takes them 3 or 4 hours to set it up. The way the colors change, and little black boxes that have like 6 or 8 lights at, they just kind of, the different parts of the concert, they just blind the audience. And it just gives you that feel that you're, you know, in a real rock concert. And that's what we're trying to make it, a real rock concert. But the rock concert is for the glorification of Jesus Christ, and, you know, not for ourselves.
One of the main things we do before our concerts is, there's several different things happen, but one of them is the counselors get together and they actually pray for the audience, for the band, for everything going on, to seek the Lord's will on it, and also to seek the Lord's blessings upon the concert. And collectively as a band, before we go out on stage, we really like to pray, to really seek the Lord's will for us on what Greg will say or what the rest of us will say, and also just pray that we'll be really receptive to what the Lord would have us do that night.
Lord, I have a personal friend that's here tonight, and I don't know if she even knows you as her Savior. And I ask that you do something special in her heart this evening. Yes.
Since there are so many obvious and some not so obvious differences between a Petra concert and a secular concert, then why use rock music?
I believe that rock music is the music or the language of this generation.
I used to be hooked on rock and roll, and I really, mainly just because I like the beat. And this Petra's beat, you know, it's just like the rock and roll beat.
I like it because it's rock music and it has to do with Christ. My parents let me listen to it.
They listen to more rock music than anything else.
What about your non-Christian friends? Do you catch grief from them for listening to this type of music?
No, some of them like it even though they're not Christians. And I think maybe through the music, maybe they'll become Christians.
They really speak to the teenagers. We work with the teenagers and youth group in our church a lot. And the kids really get a lot out of their music. It's got a lesson behind it.
It's an exciting kind of music. It's emotional. And that's what I believe that our experience with Jesus Christ should be.
Any particular song of theirs that speaks to you more than another?
Possibly Judas Kiss, because it tells about how God may have felt.
More power to you.
Not of this world, more power to you, and it is finished.
God pleaser.
I like Be the System.
Do video is really two reasons. One, we want it to be evangelistic. Primarily, that is the function of it. And if it gets on some of these stations that play videos, that's fine. We don't really think that kids ought to be watching those shows, but yet it's for the non-believer. If we can catch someone's ear by them seeing a video, that's great. Face the heat.
The group gives additional credit for their success to the involvement of local churches.